Hello and welcome to yet another episode of The Property Show, your one-stop guide on all things property. Over the years, the Kenya Homes Expo has been a successful platform for people entering into the property market and shopping around for great deals. This year, there was more on offer from international and local exhibitors. Visitors had delightful choices to pick from: interior design products, building solution options, security systems, modern kitchen fittings, different flooring options, variety of homes, plots, and holiday units. Our team was not left out and was at hand to give information on the dynamic property products. Our popular home ownership segment highlights an interesting story about someone who beat the odds to owning their dream home. Look out for Kenya Power on energy efficiency. For all this and much more, sit back, relax, and let's enjoy the show. As always, there is something for everyone. This year, the Kenya Homes Expo attracted property investors who are creating stunning neighborhoods across the country. Let's see how it went down.
The Kenya Homes Expo opened its doors yet again at the Kenyatta International Conference Center. The expo is supported by institutions from the Kenyan government and professional bodies like the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development, the Architectural Association of Kenya, among others. This is undoubtedly the biggest home show in East and Central Africa, boasting of an estimated 40,000 visitors patronizing the four-day biannual event. The expo, themed Creating Tomorrow's Lifestyle, hosts over 200 local and international exhibitors drawn from various sectors of the real estate industry. The expo saw new entrants including La Rosy Apartments with modern designs and affordable luxury in Kisumu, the refreshingly outstanding Royal Properties Limited and Property Zone with immense investment opportunities.
What is unique about Kenya projects and our budget homes, as the name suggests, budget homes, we are catering for the common person. Looking at the market today, it is so hard to get a house of 1 million, so hard to get a house of 2 million, talk of 3 million, and also looking at the locations that we are giving these houses. A good example, check like Nyali Estate, also Nairobi, where we have moved in Roiro. These houses, even without getting a mortgage, you can be able to secure what we call personal loan and still be able to own a house. That is why we encourage the low-income earners to really visit us, because in this country for so long it has been an issue of who has what to be able to own anything in this country. But today, that common person, that person who wants 50,000, who wants 30,000, even those who wants 20,000, today you have a hope of owning a home of your own, not living in a rented house forever. So that is something possible that we can be able to do, and that is why we are saying Visit Kenya Project. We really have the interest of that common person in heart.
The main purpose of Kretam starting is to buy land add value and make it affordable to each and everyone who wants to invest. And we are doing that in all the areas within various counties with a projected growth area. That is where we are investing on behalf of our members. So we add value, we do water, we do roads, we do the titles for them, we do all that's required for them, then we give them the property that is ready for investment. We have property in Laikipia County, specifically in Nanyuki. We have properties in Machakos, in Mavoko area, at the river. We have properties in Kajiado, that is Kitengela, Kisaju, and Isinya. We have properties in Nakuru County, Nakuru Town. And also we are aspiring to venture in all other areas that members need to invest. We have worked with many SACCOs. Our major project, the Green Isinya City, we have worked together with many SACCOs. We have brought together SACCOs to enhance the issues of economies of scale to provide cheap and affordable housing to various members of the society and also the members of the SACCO. So our products are affordable and we target all classes of people. We target any person with an interest to invest. We'll always come up with a solution for them, irrespective of their financial position at that time.
And we started after we saw the need to bring in affordable homes, especially homes which are below 1 million shillings. Currently, all our properties in Kabete are fully let. Target market is students and young executives. Good finishing, tile, they have solar. Since they're affordable, people are able to get back their money within 8 years. Our current project, which is Epic Studios and one bedroom apartment, are located in Mwamuto. Mwamuto is next to New Kirisuru Estate, and it's 13 kilometers from CBD and 6-7 kilometers from Sarit Center. It's a very safe area, and the area is suitable for young executives who want to start their new lives, especially the guys who just got a new job, or newly married people. And our one-bedroom apartment is going for 1.4 million with a rental income of 15,000 shillings, while the studio apartments are going for 950,000 shillings with a rental income of 10,000 shillings, which we feel is a very good return on investment for investors and also for group or chamas who would want to come and purchase. Secondly, we think some of the options that the guys can buy is via unsecured loans, which are available from all banks.
Falcon Development Limited. We're the developers of Ngando Plaza Development, also the marketing agents of Canaan Gated Farm. What we're doing in Ngando is trying to gentrify an area that previously was disused. We started with a first project called Race Course Gardens that has gone very well. And now this is like the second phase in which you want to even further improve housing accommodation for young guys. In Canaan, you're also trying to introduce people to early retirement planning. There we are allowing somebody an opportunity to own 5 acres of land and a quarter acre for a residential building. The 5 acres is for agriculture. We work in 2-bedroom apartments, are very good for young families and for people who are looking to also rent houses to the young families. If you look at the parcel of land also, it's very affordable. The 5 acres goes for 1.5 million. I doubt you can get any other similar product in this expo. The expo, definitely because you get a wide cross-section of Kenyans from all walks of life, and it's also an opportunity to interface with people without having, okay, for them it's comfortable because they don't have to immediately commit, but they get to see their options, and they know they're making the best choice when they're here.
Homeowners and investors, Looking to buy property today? The Kenya Homes Expo is a great place to start your search. For more information on upcoming expos and events, call on us. Moving on, at the expo, we caught up with leading providers offering bespoke furniture, decor, roofing materials, cables, solar solutions, and much more. Let's have a look.
Of interior was also on the spotlight, with some of the new entrants including Mega Deco Interiors, specializing in supplying home fittings, the Camera Technology Systems for security, and Elite Pavers Outdoor Tiles, with easy to maintain carburos in different models, shapes, and colors. Locally made, thus readily available.
We have the box profiles, we have all these profiles, the tile profiles, and currently we are showcasing our stone coat profile, which is a lifestyle. So we have an offer on it. It's running at a discount right now. So we're really trying to encourage people to appreciate quality. It's been tested and tried, and it also comes with a 50-year warranty. So we are guaranteeing you that it's a product that will last, and it's our premium product. What is unique about Mabati Rolling Mill products? One, we're a Kenyan company, a Kenyan flagship, so buy Kenya, build Kenya. Two, we have been in the industry for over 50 years, so we can attest to you that when we give you a product, it's been tested and tried over the years, and we have done innovations to constantly improve on our products. So that's what we offer you. We guarantee you on our quality and the premium in the market. You won't find this anywhere else.
Household furniture, and we have the dining sets, we have the bedroom, we have the breakfast tables, the coffee tables, and also the sitting area, the wall units, and others. Lockwood Africa Furniture, we import our wood from Congo, the DRC, then we bring them back to Kenya. We also custom make people's design, and that's why we call it a locally made from here, from Kenya. Yeah. Unique about the mahogany, it comes naturally. It has a reddish color, but sometimes we stain them according to the customer's opinion. And then it's, when you carve it, it's easy to carve. It's easy to furnish it. It's always glued at some parts. So when you glue it, it gets intact to each other. That's why it's so unique about it. You come with your own designs. We make for you according to what you want. And also, if you're not satisfied, we do the best we can for you to be satisfied. Because when you leave, you go and talk to others and tell them about us.
Delta Energy Systems Kenya Limited. We are integrators and distributors of power systems and solutions in Kenya and East Africa and broad Central Africa. We have renewable power products like the solar power systems, the inverter systems. We have the solar water heating systems. We also do power protection and control, because like you need also to control power. Sometimes it can be dangerous. We do that by voltage stabilizers to ensure that individuals are safe in their houses and their premises. And we also aim at scenarios whereby we can always go green by doing much in the renewable energy sector, trying to introduce affordable, reliable, and sustainable solutions for homes for this generation and generations to come. The reason why we've come to this expo, actually we are aiming at ensuring that our clients and the homeowners also get reliable power, because you cannot own a home or have a house without power. Power is in everyday's life, and people are looking at now power that is affordable, renewable energy that is free from environmental damages and also cost effective. You see, solar is a renewable energy. You can use it and use it again and again.
East African Cables primarily manufactures electrical cables, what we call low voltage cables, that are used for house wiring, for your electricity, that are used by the utility companies for the transmission and distribution of power, and also that are used for the pulling of power from transformers into buildings. As you can see, we have two companies represented here. We have East African Cables and another company that is under Transcentury called Avery East Africa. And we come at the expo because we are here to meet developers. The products that we sell in this umbrella of companies are targeted to developers. I mentioned earlier, East African Cables does electrical cables. Every home that is being constructed right now needs cables. Every building, hotel, mall needs cables. And we are here to meet the developers that are yet to do from their home where they're going to live in, or any serial developer that is developing buildings or houses that are for rental or for selling. In this same stand, we have Avery East Africa that sell generators, weigh bridges, and those are targeted again to the homeowners or the developers who need generators for the developments that they're doing.
Are you looking to transform your space with the latest trends? In the coming weeks, we continue bringing fresh ideas for your interior options. Next, would you like to make your logo more appealing and give it a visual identity? Well, let's see how you can do it.
Ident is a company that gives identity to other companies and projects. Ident does 3D architectural visualization and branding. We make the renders make a reality for the client so that they can have a real view of what their project will end up looking like. We've come to the expo so people can see who we are and get to know about us and to create awareness of our projects and stuff that we do. Once we have an interested client, we take a floor map and then we do our 3D renders and we add interior and exterior designs, and then we send them the copy, and if they approve, we continue with our process and then we go ahead with the building.
Have creative products you'd like to highlight, the property show is open to you. We take a short break. Still ahead, Kenya Power, home ownership journey, and property gallery. Don't go away. Welcome back. Coming up, a story that beats the odds to home ownership. A collection of properties and plots, and Kenya Power on energy efficiency. It's estimated that if we get into the habit of conserving energy, collectively we can save almost 2 billion Kenya shillings per annum. That sounds like a great reason to jump onto the energy conservation bandwagon, don't you think? Keep watching and learn more.
annual Energy Awards targets all energy consumers. It is geared at encouraging a culture of energy efficiency and conservation and recognizes enterprises that have made major and sustainable gains in energy efficiency through the application of modern energy management principles and practices, and in the process made significant energy and cost reductions.
We are trying to grow our economy as a country, and I think it's important, even as we grow, that we grow in a green manner. And so tonight's landmark achievement is our concerted effort to conserve energy, and this cannot be understated. Our theme, Numbers Don't Lie, 12 billion saved, is the theme for the event. And this is for us a jubilant pronouncement of how much can be attained through employment of efficient energy management strategies. At the end of this day, it is said that nature is not a place to visit, it is home. Which is why industry is deliberate in joining the front line to lead this initiative. So ladies and gentlemen, the government, and in particular, the Ministry of Energy and Petroleum, will continue to remain a key partner in pushing forward the energy agenda.
Let us recount what the government has done so far. 2 years ago, we had 1.9 million households which were connected to power. Today, we have 4.4 million. In the last 12 months, 1 million new households have been connected to the grid. We have 60,000 kilometers of medium voltage power lines all over the country. This program is still ongoing. Ladies and gentlemen, the 60,000 kilometers is not a small feat. 52 towns have been earmarked for street lighting. 12 have been completed. The other 40 are all over the country. We are seeing, as manufacturers, as private sector, an economy that is growing rapidly outside of the main urban areas. This was not the case any time before in the last 20 years in our economy.
This occasion is significant because much of the time we take in the energy sector, we put our focus on the supply side. But today, we are focusing on the demand side to ensure that whatever we generate, we are able to use it efficiently. Energy is a prime driver of industrial growth and a major factor of production. But of course, additional generation comes with additional costs. That's why it's crucial that we are able to utilize whatever we have available in the most efficient way. If I indulge in my capacity as a regulator, we have a lot of relationship to work with the EMA Awards because of the nexus between what we do on energy efficiency and renewable energy and what CAM aspires to do. And we have particular regulations that address specific issues on energy management. These are on solar. We have recently drafted some for our appliances so that the fridges used in our houses, ACs, and motors, industrial motors, can be more efficient. And they'll be coming in the course of the next year.
We have seen very many programs taking place that impact directly on the common life of the Mwananchi. Starting with the 5,000 megawatts program, which has now made us exit the rationing regime to a regime where we can now say we have excess power. We have the last mile program, Your Excellency, which is an initiative of getting the last mile to the customer. And this, amongst other initiatives, is going to enable us attain 70% access by June 2017. That has made it possible, Your Excellency, for us to now double the number of customers since 2013. For only the 3 years, we have been able to increase the number of customers who had come on board in a period of more than 90 years.
I congratulate the industry for coming together every year for a conversation about efficient utilization of energy resources, which today goes hand in hand with the responsibility to conserve and protect the environment for future generations. Reliable and competitively priced energy is the essential driver of industry and subsequently for economic development. Kenya is presently in the forefront among African countries in employing energy efficient management systems. And that is apparent to us in government because we must do the right thing and make sure that we do not just have energy, but to eliminate carbon footprints and uses that do not give us value for our investment. And I guess that is the reason why this award was set up, to profile and appreciate companies who employ energy efficient mechanisms in their places of work. And I'm very proud that this evening we can comfortably say that we have, over the last 12 years, because of this initiative, we have saved 12 billion shillings. That is not small money by any count.
As an investor or a developer, there are many things you have to consider as you embark on your development project. One such critical and important thing is power. As you make plans for your development, it is important that you approach Kenya Power at the earliest stage possible. This will guarantee that as your development project proceeds, your plans for power are also ongoing. And with an additional 5,000 megawatts of electricity being injected into the power grid, you can be guaranteed that power costs are definitely coming down. Plan for power as you embark on your development project.
How do you defy the odds to home ownership? Our next guest shares her experience.
I'm a mother of two, a grandmother of one, and I'm a business lady. I thought of home ownership when he was still in the university with my late husband, who was an architect, and we started talking about how we'd build a home. One time we had gone to see my auntie, who was one of the richest ladies in Embu. And when I went there, so I came and told my husband that when I was in primary, I went to my auntie's home. And since our home was not that standard, as goes her, she was quite okay in terms of home. Her home was very beautiful, and I developed a desire to own such a home. So one time when I got married to my husband, because I got married to him when I was still in campus, when I took him to my auntie's home, that is when he said, that he was also going to try and build a home which was similar to hers, but he did some changes. But the actual plan was as per what he saw in that magazine. But we really didn't know how to start and when to start. But we had to start somewhere. What happened is that when Karinge got employed, he started looking for private jobs. And some of his old wazees are the ones who gave him some private business to do, to draw plans for them. He would get some money, and then with that money we were able to buy the plot on which this house is, which was in 1987, and we paid in small installments. Then in 1987 is when he started building the home, and we actually faced certain challenges because getting finances when from the bank was a tall order. So we built the house for 7 years, from 1987 to 1993. And we came here when the house was not complete. It was halfway done. So we moved upstairs where we were cooking, and also where we were sleeping in one room. And we continued building slowly. And then he continued getting more and more people who gave him some little money. We also had some suppliers who were very kind to us. We didn't have any collateral, So, and anytime when you go to a bank for a loan, they always want to get a, you have to give them a collateral security, which we didn't have. That is why we took so long to build the home, because in most cases, like when you have a bank loan, you'll be able to build very fast. So it took a whole 7 years to build the home. And then also the other challenges we faced was the theft of materials by our employees. And there are times they would also run away because we didn't have money to pay them. But over time, my husband learned how to deal with them. And so we were able to continue despite the challenges. Some of the benefits are that you take time to build your own home the way you want. You design your own house. And then you can also make the changes as you want. The other thing is that you also save on rent. And it is said that if you want to go fast, you walk alone. But if you want to go far, you work with people. We realize the power of negotiation is very important. Asking to be given time to pay, other than paying everything at once, because we also had limited resources. So when you talk to people and tell them about, and be honest, because honesty is very, very important if you want to grow. The people who supported us gave us a lot of support, so we were comfortable. We didn't have so much stress, though of course it took longer to complete the house. And even the employees, when you talk to them, or the people who are working for you and maybe you don't have money, what my husband did is he always made sure there was food. He would cook for them ugali. Then he would tell them that because I don't have money today, wait, after some time, I'm going to pay you the cost of the week. And he listened. So it's a matter of talking to people. And it all depends on how you carry yourself and the words you use.
Next, we've lined up a selection of properties and plots available in the market.
Located along South Lake Road in Naivasha, a spectacular lakefront, Osutua Villas is an upcoming development designed to offer comfort, privacy, and freedom. There are 54 elegantly designed holiday homes. The land at the lakefront will house the temporary structure to conferencing, wedding gardens, and boat deck. The holiday homes will consist of 32 studio units, 7 2-bedrooms, 15 3-bedrooms, and a penthouse. Each unit will be fully furnished. The eco-furnished holiday units are unique in construction to blend with the environment. The variety of services, amenities, and activities around the area offer great experiences to individuals and families. Accommodation includes entry lobby, spacious lounge opening to the backyard, spacious dining area, breakfast area, fully fitted kitchen, visitor's cloakroom, guest room that can act as a domestic servant's quarter, bar area, mahogany staircase, first and second bedroom ensuite, and master ensuite. Salient features include 24-hour manned gate, CCTV, perimeter wall with electric fencing, cobble-paved roads, carport in each unit, borehole, water tanks, solar water heater, manicured gardens, swimming pool, gym overlooking the lake, commercial center that will house the penthouse, studio units, conference facilities, spa, and a restaurant. The price for the 3-bedroom unit is 37 million Kenya shillings with a rental income of 30,000 Kenya shillings per night. The price for the 2-bedroom units is 35 million Kenya shillings and a rental income of 25,000 Kenya shillings per night. The price for the studio units ranges from 19 to 21 million Kenya shillings with rental income of 15,000 Kenya shillings per night. Penthouse goes for 50 million Kenya shillings. Loresha Greens is a secure gated apartment comprising of 15 blocks each with 10 units of 2 and 3 bedrooms. The two upper floors are two bedrooms of 140 square meters, and the lower ones are three bedrooms of 165 square meters. Situated in the heart of Loreto, the apartments overlook the Vet Club golf course, providing scenic views. Accommodation includes spacious lounge leading to the balcony, dining area, spacious kitchen with a balcony, spacious corridor that doubles as a study area or storage space. First and second bedrooms share a common bathroom, master ensuite, utility area, anti-theft door, and domestic servant quarter. Salient features include CCTV, man gate, perimeter wall, electric fence with razor wire, children's playground, swimming pool, gym, pressure tanks, borehole, generator, manicured gardens, patio area, wire wall, and cobble-paved parking. The price for the three-bedroom units is 15 million Kenya shillings with an investment return of 85,000 Kenya shillings per month. And for the two-bedroom units, the price is 13 million Kenya shillings with an investment return of 65,000 Kenya shillings per month. Korumpoi Gated Estate is a controlled development for housing construction with available house plans for one to build. Each house sits on an eighth of an acre. The gated estate is expected to have at least 80 houses with all the required amenities. The homes are colorfully and tastefully designed, making it perfect for a young family. Accommodation includes an entry porch, a spacious lounge with space for a dining table, large windows to allow in natural light and for ventilation, Italian tiled floors for glossy look, bamboo ceilings for a cozy feel, spacious kitchen with enough cabinets and space for cooker, cubby hole for easy access of the dining area, granite kitchen tops for easy maintenance, spacious corridor, pantry, utility area, two bedrooms sharing a common bathroom and cloakroom, master bedroom ensuite, enough wardrobes in all the bedrooms, and great indoor and outdoor finishes. Salient features include piped water, septic tanks, extra storage tanks, parking space for two, electricity, 24-hour manned security gate with close proximity to the police station, perimeter wall, manicured gardens, all-weather roads, and all-round fence in each home. The price guide is 5.5 million Kenya shillings. You also have the option of buying an eighth of an acre plot for 975,000 Kenya shillings. The ACL plots are located in Kitengela in a quiet, serene and level terrain ready for development. The plots are an eighth of an acre with amenities such as water and electricity available for connection. It is 3 kilometers off the Kitengela-Namanga Road at the Olutoroto Junction near the KAG University. The price guide for these plots is 800,000 Kenya shillings each. Don't miss this opportunity to own a plot. Acres at Mulolongo. Located off Mombasa Road at Mulolongo, Mavoko Municipality with access from Beijing Road. The land is 20 minutes drive from the Nairobi City Centre and 5 minutes from the Sokyumau train station. These 75 acres are divided into parcels of 5 acres and 2.5 acres. These plots are ideal for both commercial and residential developments as they are only 1 kilometer from the main all-weather access road. Residential communities in the area are Olenyori Estate and Great Wall Apartments. The plots are also in close proximity to the Athi River Town and the major banks. Schools within the area include Joyland Preparatory School and Kitengela International School. Price available on request. Golden Pearl is situated on the Thika Gatanga Road off Thika Superhighway. It gives you all the amenities of a controlled development and impresses with its location, environs, and scenic views. Golden Pearl contains 3 blocks of land designed with different themes including Palm Island, Melville Island, and Wellington Island. Features include
water, electricity, state-of-the-art gate with 24-hour CCTV surveillance and perimeter wall, shopping arcade with cafe, mini-mart, beauty parlors and offices, park complete with a fitness center, an aerobic swimming pool, basketball court, tennis court, skating pathways, Wi-Fi and manicured grass, garbage collection point, nursery school, beautiful lagoon with natural pathways, gazebos, well-manicured picnic grounds and fishing, a bridge connecting Melville to Wellington Island, pedestrian walk and bike provisions, and police post. The price for a quarter an acre is 5.2 million Kenya shillings.
If you're a developer or a property manager interested in featuring your projects on the Property Show platform, simply text us on the numbers shown on the screen and we'll get back to you. Property Show has local knowledge and understand the property landscape. To keep up with the latest trends in the market, register with us through our digital platforms and we'll keep you informed. Next Sunday, we zero in on various satellite developments, the next frontier with hot deals. Our bus tour is here with us again. Register and find your dream home. Thank you for joining us and keep watching The Property Show for all things property. Remember, there is something for everyone. Kwaheri.